The opportunity to be one of the charter members studying the E-legs is really very important, especially for the field, to really move it forward. As we have a chance to look at some of the new exoskeleton devices, we'll have a chance to enhance mobility for people with spinal cord injury, as well as enhance the science of what's going on. We will have input into further development of these devices with the company and with the other centers that are also charter members studying this.
It wasn't until I was laying on the table and they were strapping all these sensors and just wiring me all up that I blasted into this like space of awe that I had only been in when I fell. The night I fell, it was the same. I looked around the room and I was just like, we are all here doing something so important, and we're all a part of something so big right now. Realizing that I was gonna be the first person for this particular robot. They wanted to get the research on what happens to your body when you sit, stand, and then walk if you're paralyzed. It was just a phenomenal experience.
We had six individuals of varying spinal cord injury level use the exoskeleton, and without exception, all six of them walked over ground. So they would come in for an hour, and within that hour they were placed into the exoskeleton device and were able to walk over ground. And we recorded their walking speed and some walking distance on the individuals as well. Without doubt, all of these individuals had such a positive experience, such an exhilarating experience of them being able to walk for such a lengthy period of time and giving them that independence.
I was thinking maybe I was going to feel like a bag of bones once I stood up, because I was the first quad to try it. Prior to that, it was only paras that tried it, and they have their whole upper body and upper body strength, and I was just a little nervous that I wasn't going to be stable. I leaned forward, pushed up, and the unit just stood me up. It was one of the most unbelievable feelings I've ever had. We just started walking, and I was up for an hour and 10 minutes, 31 minutes of actual walking, and I believe they said it was like 520 steps. The initial feedback I got was that I did unbelievable. Nobody knew what to expect because I was the highest level to have tried it.
Yeah, let's run.
What is the advantage of walking over ground an hour a day or a half an hour a day on a regular basis compared to being in the chair? What are the advantages to the health and well-being, the cardiovascular problems, the trunk, the posture, the breathing problems, being able to, does it affect your breathing, the fact that you're able to now have maybe have a different or a stronger trunk from using this device? How does that change the way you breathe? So I think they're the questions that we can ask, and having this device allows us to answer those questions. And so the very big question is, what is the advantage of having people standing up versus them pushing around in a chair all day? How does that help them on a physiological point of view?
I hope a lot of other people get to use this, because it was just an unbelievable feeling. And to know that somebody my level can do this now, C6, C7, is great, that it opens it up to so many other people out there.
Every little bit of research and data will support those trials and making the Ekso available for people.
Kessler Foundation, discoveries that change lives.